So today we are going to do the acceleration analysis of crank and slotted lever mechanism in this video. So this video is related to the Coriolis component of acceleration. Problem statement: figure shows a quick return mechanism of a slotted lever type, the various dimensions of which are OA 400 mm, OP 200 mm, AR 700 mm, RS 300 mm. Determine the acceleration of the cutting tool at S, the angular acceleration of link RS. The crank OP rotates at 210 rpm. So the crank is rotating in clockwise direction as shown in figure, and the line of stroke of slider S is 350 mm above point O. So first step is to draw the space diagram. Over here I have taken a scale, 1 cm is equals to 100 mm to draw the space diagram, and accordingly I have drawn the space diagram. So here you need to focus on the angle of inclination of crank. It is given with respect to vertical, so be careful while drawing this angle 120 degree. It is from vertical. Now in the problem statement they have given the angular velocity of the crank, it is 22 radian per second. So from RPM I have calculated this value. Now to draw the velocity diagram, the first step is to find out the linear velocity of the crank. So velocity of crank is equals to R, R is distance OP into omega, omega PO. So OP distance, it is 200 mm. So in meters it is 0.2, 0.2 into 22. So we'll get the velocity of piston, sorry, the velocity of crank as 4.4 meter per second. So the velocity of crank we have got. Now to draw the velocity diagram, first of all select a scale. So for velocity diagram I am going to select a scale, 1 centimeter equals to 1 meter per second. Now select a reference point having zero velocity, representing zero velocity. So in this diagram A is fixed, O is fixed, and the slot G is fixed. So these points will coincide with the reference point. So A, O and G coincides with the reference point. Now the first step is to draw the velocity vector for crank OP. The crank OP is rotating in clockwise direction, hence its velocity vector will lead OP, capital OP, by 90 degree. To draw a line perpendicular to capital OP in the direction of rotation from small O. Now the distance between small O and small P point is 4.4 centimeter, as the velocity of P relative to A is 4.4 meter per second, and our scale is 1 centimeter is equals to 1 meter per second. So mark a point at a distance of 4.4 centimeters from point small O. So we have got the position of point P over here. Draw vector OP. Now next step, we have got the position of point P. P from the space diagram, it is the slider which is sliding along link AR. So P we'll consider on slider, and the position of same point on link AR we'll consider it by point Q. So now we need to draw the linear velocity of the slider. The slider is sliding along link AR. Hence, its linear velocity will be parallel to AR. So draw a line parallel to AR from point small P. Now, the line that we have drawn will represent the direction of linear velocity of the slider, but we don't know the position of point Q on this velocity vector. Now, Q point is a point which is on AR, and AR link is oscillating about point A. So, its velocity vector will be 90 degree ahead of its position. So draw a line perpendicular to AR from point small a representing the velocity of link AR. The point of intersection of these two lines is nothing but point Q. So join PQ as I have drawn the arrowhead towards point Q. The vector is read as VQP. So we have got the position of point Q. The point small r will be next to the point Q on the same velocity vector that we have drawn. So we are going to find out the position of this small r by using the proportions, that is small ar divided by small aq is equals to capital AR divided by capital AQ. So small AR distance we need to find out, small AQ we are going to get it from the velocity diagram. So major distance AQ from velocity diagram, the distance between AQ point is 3.3 centimeters. So AR upon 3.3, you need not to consider any scale factor as it is 1 centimeter is equals to 1 meter per second, and AR distance is 700 divided by AQ. AQ is not directly given in the problem statement, so measure the distance between point AQ. So it is 5.3 centimeters, that is 530 mm. So the distance AR we are going to calculate. So it comes out to be 4.36 centimeters. So mark a point R at a distance of 4.36 from point A, small a. So we have got the position of point R. So join AR now. After R we need to mark the position of point S on the velocity diagram. Now RS is the link having oscillatory motion, hence its velocity vector will be perpendicular to capital RS. So from point small r, draw a line perpendicular to RS So we don't know the magnitude, we are going to mark the direction of this velocity vector. Now S is the point which is present on the link RS as well as on the slider. So if I want to represent the velocity of the slider is sliding along the line of stroke. Hence, its linear velocity can be drawn parallel to the line of stroke. So draw a line parallel to the line of stroke from point small g, representing the linear velocity of the slider. The point of intersection of the two lines will represent point S. So V, S, G, that is velocity of slider relative to the slot, and V, S, R, that is the velocity of link R, S. So this is our velocity diagram. To draw the acceleration diagram, I am going to collect the data in a tabulated format. So first thing that we are going to find out is the centripetal acceleration of crank. So the centripetal acceleration of P relative to O, we do know its formula is V square upon R. So V P O square divided by R means the distance between point capital O and capital P in meters. So VPO we have already calculated, it is 4.4 meter per second, 4.4 square divided by 0.2 meters is the length of link OP. So the acceleration is 96.8 meter per second square, and its direction, as it is centripetal acceleration, it will be parallel to OP but opposite in sense, as it leads the position by 180 degree, hence its sense will be opposite. Now the second is the tangential acceleration of link OP. There is no data given related to the angular acceleration of the crank, hence we will consider that the crank is rotating at uniform angular velocity, so its angular acceleration is zero, hence the tangential acceleration of crank is zero. So the centripetal acceleration represents the total acceleration of the crank. So OP we have found out at point P, there is slider. So find out the Coriolis component of acceleration of the slider. So Coriolis component of acceleration Q relative to P, it will be twice into velocity of slider, so V QP into omega. But omega, that is the angular velocity, we need to consider of the link on which the slider is sliding. So we need to find out the angular velocity of link AR. So to find out the angular velocity of AR, we do know the linear velocity of link AR. It can be represented as a product of AR into omega RA, that is R into omega. So omega RA will be equals to VRA upon capital AR. So VRA, that is the velocity of point R relative to A. We have also found out the distance between small AR point, it is 4.36 centimeters, means according to our scale, it is 4.36 meter per second. So velocity A आर ए इज 4.36 मीटर पर सेकेंड डिवाइड बाय द लेंथ ऑफ लिंक ए आर. द लेंथ ऑफ लिंक ए आर इज 700 mm, सो 0.7 मीटर्स. सो द एंगुलर वेलोसिटी ऑफ द लिंक ए आर विल बी 6.228 रेडियन पर सेकेंड. सो इन द फॉर्मूला ऑफ करिलीज कंपोनेंट वी आर गोइंग टू पुट ऑल दीज वैल्यूज. सो 2 इंटू वी क्यूब पी, दैट इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ स्लाइडर. कैलकुलेट मेजर इट फ्रॉम द वेलोसिटी डायग्राम. सो फ्रॉम वेलोसिटी डायग्राम द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन पॉइंट पी एंड क्यू इज 2.85 सेंटीमीटर्स. सो ऑब्वियसली इट्स वेलोसिटी इज 2.85 मीटर पर सेकेंड एज स्केल इज 1:1 इंटू ओमेगा आर ए इट इज 6.228. सो द करियूलिस कंपोनेंट ऑफ एक्सेलरेशन इज 35.50 मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वेयर. इट्स डायरेक्शन विल बी परपेंडिकुलर टू ए आर. इट्स डायरेक्शन विल बी परपेंडिकुलर टू ए आर, बट वी डोंट नो वेदर इट इज ऑन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड और इट विल लाई ऑन राइट हैंड साइड. सो दैट विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल वाइल ड्राइंग द एक्सेलरेशन डायग्राम. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज द लीनियर एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ स्लाइडर P, that is the acceleration of slider Q relative to P. Its magnitude is unknown, but direction. So the slider P is sliding along AR, hence its direction will be parallel to its motion. So its direction will be parallel to AR. Okay. Now next is to find out the centripetal acceleration of q relative to p, because we are going to get the position of q point. Hence we are going to find out the centripetal acceleration of q relative to not p sorry q relative to a. First of all, as the q point is considered on link AR, so we are going to find out the centripetal acceleration of Q relative to A. So centripetal acceleration is V square, so VQA square divided by distance AQ. So the distance between AQ point from velocity diagram, so the distance between AQ point is 3.3 centimeters. So the velocity is 3.3 meter per second, so 3.3 square divided by AQ distance. AQ distance we have measured, it is 530 mm, so it is 0.53 meters. So 3.3 square divided by 0.53, 20.55 meter per second square is the centripetal acceleration of Q relative to A. Its direction, as it is centripetal acceleration, it will be parallel to AQ but opposite in sense. The next centripetal acceleration we have found out. Now next is the tangential acceleration of Q relative to A. So its magnitude, we don't know the angular acceleration of AQ link, so we don't know the magnitude of the tangential acceleration, but its direction, the tangential acceleration always leads the position by 90 degree, hence its direction is perpendicular to AQ. Now after Q point, obviously we are going to get the position of R, as it will lie on the same acceleration vector and it will be next to point Q on acceleration diagram. So we are going to find out the centripetal and tangential acceleration of RS link, as we are going to get r point on acceleration diagram. So we are going to find out the accelerations of link rs. So first of all, find out the centripetal acceleration of s relative to r. So it will be v s r square divided by distance capital rs. So v s r, we are going to measure it from the velocity diagram. So it is 1.45 centimeters. So 1.45 square divided by rs. Rs distance is 300 mm, so it is 0.3 meters. So 1.45 square divided by 0.3, it is 7 meter per second square. Its direction will be parallel to rs but opposite in sense. As it is the centripetal acceleration. Next is the tangential acceleration of s relative to r. Again, we don't know the angular acceleration of link rs, so the magnitude of this acceleration is unknown, but its direction, as it is tangential acceleration, it will be perpendicular to capital rs. Next, s is at point s, there is a slider. So the acceleration of the slider, which is having linear motion, will be parallel to the line of stroke. So the acceleration of slider s relative to g, its magnitude is again unknown, but direction is parallel to the line of stroke. So this data will help us to draw the acceleration diagram. To draw the acceleration diagram, I am going to consider a scale. 1 centimeter equals to 10 meter per second square. So consider a reference point having zero acceleration. So in this diagram, as we know, A, G and O is fixed, so they will coincide with the reference point. I am going to represent these by A1, O1, G1. So the nomenclature for acceleration diagram I am going to use as A1, O1, G1. Now the first vector that we are going to draw is the centripetal acceleration vector. Its magnitude is 96.8 and its direction is parallel to OP but opposite in sense. So 96.8 divided by scale is 10, so 9.68 centimeter line we need to draw for this velocity acceleration vector. Now its direction is opposite in sense. Means what? O point, from O point the P point is on left hand side, so while drawing it on acceleration diagram it must lie on right hand side. So the position of point P will be on right hand side from O1. So draw a line parallel to OP from point O1 towards right. Now the point P1 is at a distance of 9.68 centimeter. So mark a point at a distance of 9.68 centimeter from O1. So this is the position of point P1. As the centripetal acceleration is indicating the total acceleration in this case, so join point O1 P1 by solid line. The vector is ACPO, that is centripetal acceleration of P relative to O. So from point P1, we need to find out the position of point Q1. For that, we need to mark the Coriolis component of acceleration on acceleration diagram. It is 35.5 meter per second square in magnitude and perpendicular to AR, but we don't know whether it is lying on left hand side or right hand side of AR. So to find out the direction of Coriolis component, redraw the velocity vector. You need not to consider any scale. To find out the direction of Coriolis component, you just need to draw the vector as it is. So the tail point is point P and the head point is point Q. We do know that the tail point is representing the fixed end and the head point is representing the movable end. Now you need to rotate this velocity vector in the direction of rotation of the link on which the slider is placed. The slider is placed on link AR. So first of all, find out the direction of rotation of link AR. Here you need not to consider the direction of rotation of crank. As the slider is sliding along AR, you need to find out the direction of rotation of AR. So from velocity diagram, the velocity vector AR is towards right, means the linear velocity of link AR is towards right, hence it will rotate in clockwise direction about point A. So rotate VQP vector in clockwise direction about fixed point. So fixed point is P, in clockwise direction about point P through 90 degree. So you will get the direction of Coriolis component of acceleration. So Coriolis component of acceleration of Q relative to P is towards left. So from point P, the position of point Q is towards left. So draw it on the acceleration diagram. So draw a line perpendicular to AR towards left of point P1. The magnitude is 35.5 meter per second square, so divide by 10, 3.55. so the distance between P1 and Q point is 3.55 centimeters. So mark a point Q at a distance of 3.55. So this is not the final position of Q point, so I am not going to represent it by Q1, so I will represented by Q dash. So Q dash P1 is representing the centripetal Coriolis component of acceleration. So join Q dash P1 by dashed line. Next is to mark the linear acceleration of the slider. Its magnitude is unknown and its direction is parallel to AR. So draw a line parallel to AR. Already the line P1 Q dash we have drawn perpendicular to AR. So draw a line perpendicular to Q dash P1. So a line must be drawn from Q dash perpendicular to Q dash P1, representing the direction of the linear acceleration of the slider. So the Q1 point will lie on this line, but we don't know the magnitude. So we are going to consider link AR. The Q point is on link AR. So we are going to take help of this AQ. So for AQ, we have found out the centripetal acceleration. It is 20.55 and its direction is parallel to AQ, but opposite in sense. So Q point is above capital A in space diagram. So in acceleration diagram, from A1 you should draw it on you should draw it below A1. So draw a line parallel to AR from point small A1. The magnitude is 20.55, so according to our scale it is 2.05 centimeters. So mark a point at a distance of 2.05 on this line. So this is again not the final position of Q point, so I will represent it by Q double dash. So A1 Q double dash is representing the centripetal acceleration of Q relative to A. So join it by dashed line. Next is the tangential acceleration of link AQ. It is unknown in magnitude, but its direction is perpendicular to AQ. So draw a line perpendicular to AQ from point Q double dash. Here you can see that the two lines are intersecting at a common point. So this common point is nothing but Q1. So we have got the position of Q1. So Q double dash Q1 is the tangential acceleration. So join the two points by dash line. It is representing the tangential acceleration of Q relative to A. Join Q dash Q1 again by dash line. It is representing the linear acceleration of slider Q relative to P. So we have got Q1, join A1 Q1 by solid line. On the extension of this line we are going to get the point R. So to find out the position of point R1 on the acceleration diagram, we are going to make use of the proportions. So again A1 R1 upon A1 Q1 will be equals to capital AR upon capital AQ. So A1 R1 we need to find out from acceleration diagram. Measure the distance between A1 Q1. So A1 Q1 distance is 3.45 centimeters. You need not to consider scale factor while finding out such a distance of intermediate or extended points. So AR is 700 divided by AQ is 530. So A1 R1 will be equals to 4.55 centimeters. So mark a point at a distance of 4.55 from A1. So this is the point R1. So now we have got point R1. So from R1 you need to mark the position of point S, that is the slider. So for that we are going to mark the centripetal acceleration from point R1. The centripetal acceleration is 7 meter per second square and its direction is parallel to RS. So draw a line parallel to RS, but it should be opposite in sense, means S point is towards right hand side in space diagram. So in acceleration diagram it must lie on left hand side of point R. So draw a line parallel to RS from point small r1. Mark point S1 at a distance of 7, means 7 divided by 10, 0.7 centimeters from R1 towards left. So 0.7 at a distance of 0.7, we are going to get the point S. So it is not the final position of point S, so I am going to represent it by S dash. So R1 S dash is representing the centripetal acceleration. The line is representing the centripetal acceleration of S relative to R. Now the tangential acceleration, the tangential acceleration of link RS is perpendicular to RS from point S dash. You need to draw a line perpendicular to RS, capital RS. So already we have drawn S dash R1 parallel to capital RS, so directly you can draw the line perpendicular to S dash R1. So this line is representing the tangential acceleration of RS link. Now S is the common point for slider and link RS. So the slider is sliding along the line of stroke, hence its acceleration will be parallel to the line of stroke. So draw a line parallel to the line of stroke of the slider S from point G1, representing the linear acceleration of slider S. The point of intersection of these two lines is nothing but point S1. So join S1 G1 by solid line. It is representing the acceleration of S relative to G. Join S dash S1 by dashed line, as it is representing the tangential acceleration, the tangential acceleration of S relative to R. Join S1 R1 by solid line. It will represent the total acceleration of the link RS. So this is our acceleration diagram. So we need to find out the acceleration of slider S. So the acceleration of slider S is represented by line G1 S1 in acceleration diagram. So the acceleration of slider S relative to G will be equals to the distance between point G1 S1 into scale. So measure the distance between, distance between G1 S1 is 3.3 centimeters. So 3.3 into scale is 10. So it is 33 meter per second square. So the tool at S is having acceleration 33 meter per second square. So to find out the angular acceleration of link RS, that is alpha SR, we do know the tangential acceleration of SR will be equals to R into alpha. So R in this case will be distance RS into alpha SR. So alpha SR will be equals to the tangential acceleration of link RS divided by distance capital RS. So first of all, find out the tangential acceleration of link RS from the acceleration diagram. The tangential acceleration of RS is indicated by line S dash S1. So the distance S dash S1 into scale is the tangential acceleration of link RS. So the distance between S dash S1 is 1.6 centimeter. So 1.6 into 10, that is 16 meter per second square is the tangential acceleration of link RS. So alpha, that is angular acceleration of link RS, will be equals to 16 divided by RS. RS distance is 0.3 meter, so 16 divided by 0.3, 53.33 radian per second square is the angular acceleration of link RS.